What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to be going over the NametagEdit plugin. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. In the world of Minecraft server hosting, you want to make sure that your players are getting some special permissions, like ranks or cosmetics, since these are sought after by a ton of players. You could use something like LuckPerms, where a player's rank can appear in the chat, but if you're looking to take it one step farther, then that is where the NametagEdit is going to come in. This Spigot plugin allows custom prefixes and suffixes to appear above a player's head and inside of the tab menu. This can be used to set unique prefixes for individual players or even for entire server groups. Let's go over how to get started. Head to the NametagEdit Spigot page, which we will have linked below. Near the top right, click the blue download button, and then save the jar file to a safe location because we will need it in just a moment. If Spigot is unavailable for any reason, the plugin can also be downloaded off of the Jenkins page. Go to the NametagEdit dev releases page linked below, and then under last successful artifacts, find NametagEdit jar. Click the link to download the file directly and save the file in a safe location. Head into your Apex server panel and stop the server. Scroll down to the game file section and make note of the current version, while also making sure that the version is plugin compatible, like Paper or Spigot. Afterwards, enter the FTP file access in the left-hand menu and log in. On the next page, find or create the plugins folder and then enter it, and press upload in the top left and drag and drop the jar file onto the right side. Once it's 100% downloaded, return to the main panel page and then restart the server. Once the server is back online, NametagEdit should now be loaded and available for you to use. In order to set a prefix for an individual player, you will want to use the /NTEPlayer command in game. You will want to use this command, replacing the player and text with your desired options. If it's successful, you can now hold Tab to view the player list and see the new prefix added to the game. This can also be removed at any time with the /NTEPlayer name clear command later on. In order to create a group prefix, you first have to add a new group and permission inside of the plugin. You can do this by adding these two commands. Now, like before, you will want to use a command to set a custom prefix or suffix to anything that you want to for the group. From here, you will want to use a permissions plugin like LuckPerms to give the desired group the custom permission that you set. If it's successful, the prefix or suffix you choose will appear in the tab menu like before. If the basic formatting is not enough, NametagEdit is also compatible with other plugins like Essentials X and Placeholder API, allowing you to have placeholders and text formatting as part of the name tag. If you're using Essentials X, you can use the color and text formatting included in the plugin. This can provide colored ranks, names, and more simply by including the codes in the prefix command. If a plugin like Placeholder API is used, the downloaded placeholders can also be used as part of the name tag. This can be helpful for displaying currency, the current time, and much more. Now let's go over some common issues. If you get an unknown command error, make sure that the plugin was installed correctly and that you're using a plugin compatible version. After you check that, use /plugins in game to check for any installed plugins. And if none are listed, make sure that the jar file was uploaded into the correct folder in your FTP. If the NametagEdit appears in red and the commands give an internal error, it can mean that the plugin is either not updated or not functional on the latest version. First, try to download the jar file from Jenkins and replace the jar file in your FTP. If issues still occur, then the server version might not be compatible and it might require a plugin update from the author. That's how to use the NametagEdit plugin and how to install it. This is a great way to give players a little bit more customization when they're on your server, and it looks a whole lot cooler to see your name tag above your head when you push tab. Don't forget to use it with other plugins to help customize it even further. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.